Welcome. The topic of this video is Compton.conf. Compton has been updated, and this is the date up here. And it went from Compton point 4, actually, not point, but 4 to Compton 5, which is a big step in the sense that a lot of things, commands that we used to have are now depreciated and give us warning. So we have created a new Compton conf, and Compton is used on Arch Linux. We have 12 desktops at this point in time. It's used in Awesome. It's used in BSPWM, in i3, in OpenBox, and in Xmonad. So all these five are in some way, influenced by Compton and the Compton.conf. And I don't believe you. What you're looking at is Arch Linux B, but it doesn't matter if it's Xmonad or anything else. The Compton file is the same on any of these guys. So Xmonad has it in here, in this folder, is the Compton.conf, and that's the new one. And that's the original coming from the Compton GitHub. This is ours. Now, I've tweaked it a little bit more in the sense that the new Compton.conf just has one extra line. And this extra line is an important one because we're always working on VirtualBox, always testing out systems. When I discovered that VirtualBox has, if you go full screen with Control F, there's a shortcut to go full screen in VirtualBox, then on some of the desktops, maybe not all, but certainly on Xmonad, on which I'm working now, then it becomes shaded. It becomes darker, not bright, and darkens the colors. So the only thing we need to do, apparently, is say, forget about the shadow exclude, don't do that when it's a virtual box. So that code is in there, so you can forget it. It's there. So the video is actually not for the Arch Linux people, for everybody else who has a Compton.conf at some point in time and figures out or finds out that virtual box is darkened somehow. And there's already, I think we put it already on the website. Let's have a look. And go to the website. This is probably going to explain. Close everything else. Gone. And in the beta, we see already what we did in version 1902.4. This is what happened to the system. So this is VirtualBox, and it became all dark. And this is our solution. And the code that you have to include for that is this code up here. Line 39 inside shadow exclude, and then everything will be just fine. So that's the point of the video. It's for everybody else using Compton.conf, the Compton manager, and this is the solution to make VirtualBox look bright again. All right, have fun.